The uniform distribution is the simplest probability distribution available in Excel. It is defined by a minimum value and a maximum value. All the values in this range have an equal or uniform probability. The shape of the distribution is therefore a rectangle. Here we see a uniform distribution with a minimum of 1, and a maximum of 6. We see that the distribution is solid green. It is a continuous distribution in which the values on the horizontal axis can be any value between 1 and 6. We move from left to right over the horizontal x-axis in infinite small steps. We also have a discrete uniform distribution, where the minimum and maximum remain 1 and 6 and the distribution only includes the whole numbers in this range. We clearly see the gaps between the columns and understand that the distribution only includes the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. This uniform distribution example is of course a die. It is impossible to roll a die and get 1.22 as an outcome. The die only produces whole number outcomes. The uniform distribution is a symmetrical probability distribution. Since we can mirror the graph of the distribution in the central vertical axis that runs through the mean. How to model the uniform distribution in Excel? Although Excel does not have a function that is called uniform distribution, the RAND function produces a uniform distribution. In Excel we just type in equals RAND. Notice that we do not put any value between the parentheses. The function produces a random value between 0 and 1, or, if you like, between 0% and 100%. Clicking on F9 will update the formula and generate a new random value every time you click. If we would like to generate random data in a different range than 0 to 1, we can do this as follows. First, we need to determine the range. For our example, we take the range 5 to 12. The width of this range is 12 minus 5 equals 7. We multiply this result with the RAND function and add again 5. This will generate random values in the range specified. So, even though the random function only covers the domain between 0 and 1, we can define whatever range we like. Excel has a special function for the discrete uniform distribution, Randbetween. This function generates integers within the range specified. The function calls for a minimum and maximum, which are here named bottom and top. If we provide 1 and 6 as inputs, we get a model for our die. If we calculate the sheet by pressing F9, we can roll the die. Next topic is how to create a graph for the uniform distribution. If we copy the formula for a die and create 10,000 data points, we can run a Monte Carlo simulation. To make our calculation easier, we assign a name to this data range in the top left corner and call it data die. We create a bin list with the corresponding number of i's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. We assign the name i's to the bin array. Using the Excel frequency function, we can count the number of observations for each number of i's. If you have an older Excel version, then you might need to highlight the destination area, click on F2 to retrieve the formula, and then to press Alt, Control, and Enter simultaneously. The frequencies found should add up to 1000. Last step is to insert a histogram using the Excel charts. Again, clicking on F9 will update the graph. Now we are familiar with creating continuous and discrete uniform distributions in Excel, we can ask which phenomena we can model with a uniform distribution. The uniform distribution is used when there is either little information available, or there is much uncertainty, while the minimum and maximum values are known. An engineering example would be a leak in a pipeline of 100 km long. Anywhere between 0 and 100 km. This would be a continuous uniform distribution. Another example would be a shuttle bus that can take 10 passengers. In absence of any further details, this would be a discrete uniform distribution between 0 and 10 passengers. An example in finance would be the value of a state bond issued by a country on the brink of a financial collapse. In the best case, you will get all the money back, in the worst case you lose it all, with all values in between. The uniform distribution is fit for modeling extreme uncertainty. We have a better understanding now of the uniform distribution and understand how we can model this distribution in Excel. We know the difference between continuous and discrete uniform distributions and know in which situation to apply these distributions. Thanks for watching and good luck.